Hello and welcome to this next video on mobile repairing. In this video, we will try and look at some of the components of a mobile phone. As you can see on the screen, you will be able to see a lot of components in front of you. You may recognize some of these components and you may not be aware of some of them. Let's try and use this video to specifically understand these different components and where they are used. And these are all commonly used in most mobile phones, and there are different types in each of these components. First of all, let's try and understand some of the display related components. Now, in front of you, you will be able to see a small display component. Now, this is a display component which is placed using a soldering portion. So, the belt needs to be soldered onto the PCB. This is another type of display device. These are devices that can be, these are components that can be placed on the mobile PCB. Many a times, some display devices will require the SMD to remove them. However, some display devices can also be removed using a connecting point. There could be connectors. For example, in this display device, there's a small connector there, and we can slowly use an aligner to actually remove the display from its holding position. And it's held on to its position using a small connector on the mobile PCB. So, there are different types of display devices, and these are some of them. This is another type of display device which uses a connector to be connected to the PCB. So, this has a connecting point in it which goes and fits in into a similar connecting point placed on the mobile PCB. So, you may need to use different types of display components depending on what type of mobile phone and what PCB you are working with. So, some display devices, as we saw, will need to be soldered, some need to be just placed it using a lock screen, and some need to be placed into the connector. This is called a touchscreen pad. Now, typically, nowadays, when you have touchscreens, there is a display device which is inside the mobile phone. On top of the display device, the touchpad is placed. The touchpad is what understands or translates your touch into an action on the mobile phone. And this is typically placed on top of the display unit or the display component of a mobile phone. So, normally this is placed on top of a display, and that's how we place this touchpad or the touchscreen. For example, if you look at this particular device, let me show you the touchpad. So, the touchpad is the one on top, the black color one, as we can see, is the touchpad on top, and the display unit is basically inside the touchpad. So, when you touch on the screen, the touchpad translates your touches into commands for the mobile phone to be executed. So, the display is right behind it and the touchpad is in the front of the mobile device. So, these are some of the display devices or components as we just saw. Now, apart from this, there are many components which are typically placed on a PCB. Now, most of these components are placed using two or three ways that we have already seen in some of the earlier videos. One way of placing a component on a device is by soldering the leads of that component onto the mobile PCB. And we've used the micro soldering iron earlier to disconnect and reconnect some of these components on the mobile phone PCB. Many a times, the entire device is soldered onto the device, and you may need to use an SMD to remove those components. For example, the SIM connector or any of those might be soldered on like that. Now, these are some of the components, as you can see, the battery connector, SIM connector, charging connector, a network switch, and many other components that you can see on the mobile phone. You need to determine which component has to be removed in which way. So, wherever there is a lead, you may use the micro soldering iron to melt the soldering point and remove the particular component. If there is soldering at the back of each of the component, you will need to use the hot air gun or the SMD on the other side to melt the soldering for you to be able to remove that particular component. For example, some components are soldered on using a belt system. We've seen this in one of the earlier videos. So the camera is placed using a belt system here, and we will use an SMD to melt this and remove the particular components. So be careful on what method you need to use to remove these components. Let's try and look at some of the components. Some of these are familiar to you. This is a vibrator. We've already seen how we can remove a vibrator, test it, and replace the vibrator. Vibrator could be in different devices. The vibrator could be in different forms. What you see now is one kind of a vibrator. You'll see the two leads on it, and vibrator has basically a 3-volt motor. Similarly, this is another type of vibrator, which looks like a circular device. So these are different types of vibrators present in different devices. The next component is the camera component, and we've seen this component already in one of the earlier videos. This component uses a connector to be placed on the mobile PCB. This need not be soldered on into the mobile PCB. So it has a connecting point, which we saw in one of the earlier videos. This connecting point can be connected to the similar connecting point on the mobile PCB. So we've seen vibrator, we've seen the camera in terms of how they look at and how we can connect these components. The next component is a mic, a very small device that basically captures your voice and transmits it to the network. This is a ringer. And the third component that I would like to show you is a speaker. So these are three components which are associated with the sound. So this is a speaker, the center one is a mic, and the third one is a ringer. Now in some of the earlier videos, we also talked about mic, ringer, as well as the speakers, and it could be combined in some devices. So you need to understand which component does what function before you can repair the component easily on any mobile PCB. The next component is a charging connector. Again, there are different types of charging connectors that you may find on mobile phones. These are three different types of charging connectors. A charging connector is how the power is transmitted into the battery of a mobile phone. The small one is a mini charging connector, which has two points through which power is transmitted. The second one is a charging connector which is used or placed using a soldering part. You need an SMD to remove it. The third charging connector is a slightly complex device. It functions both as a charging device as well as a headphone device or a connecting point, as well as a connection device to a computer for data transfer. So these are multiple points that are available on this charging connector. Similarly, this is another charging connector which also has multiple functions, both to charge as well as to act as a headset connection. Now, some of these, this one needs to be placed using a soldering point. This connector requires to be soldered on in these sides onto a PCB. But some soldering connectors may not, some connectors may not require soldering. You can probably fix it directly there. This is another type of connector which can also be placed or connected onto a specific point onto the PCB. So both these cameras can be directly connected onto the PCB of a mobile phone. So when connecting these kind of cameras, normally there is a connecting point provided on the PCB. So you place the connecting point on top of it, and the connector fits in right there in that position. So it is some kind of a clip method where you can actually press it hard and it will go and fit in into tightly into that particular slot. And it's very easy to remove it and repair it or work on it. Now let's move on to another important component, which is called the IC. So IC is a very critical element on the mobile phone. This can also be called as the brain of the entire circuit. There are different types of ICs. IC is a very small component but stores a lot of information and controls a lot of functions of the mobile phone. These ICs are called lead ICs, which are placed using LEDs on one end of the IC. The ones which don't have such leads are called ball ICs, because these usually have small balls behind it which connect them to the mobile PCB. These are very expensive components, and you will need a lot of practice to train yourselves on placing these ICs on a mobile phone PCB. So that's a short introduction to the different components of a mobile phone. You have already learnt about a lot of these components in the earlier videos and have also understood how to remove them or replace them in a mobile phone PCB. Going forward, we will go a little more deeper into the chip level components and understand how we can repair or rectify defects that arise in the chip components of the mobile phone PCB. Thank you very much.